Hey guys, the Fetid Bubble here, and this is a video on how to manually update ModAPI. I do have an automatic way that, if you have a 64-bit system, is really great. Check the cards, top right or in the descriptions, or comment for that video. However, if you don't want to use that method, it doesn't work, or you have a 32-bit system, this video is for you. This is how you're going to update ModAPI to work with a new version of the forest. Keeping in mind that some specific mods may misbehave after a new update and will need to be updated themselves. If you have any issues not related to the update or you're unsure, please feel free to leave them down below and I will try to help you. As well as add new videos to this ModAPI troubleshooting series, we may be able to answer your question in one of those videos as well. Now let's get into fixing that issue manually. So now that you've closed ModAPI, one of the things you're going to want to do first, go into configs, find userconfiguration.xml, open it with your notepad or whatever you want as a text editor. You can also open notepad first, a blank notepad. You can go over here, you can type notepad, pop that up, and you can drag the file into there if you don't have a right click open with. And you're going to want to look through this for the first part right here. What I've highlighted is this auto update faults, update versions faults. Set update done. There are some other things in here you can mess around with. Most of these options can be changed inside of the inside of ModAPI. There's some that can't, so if you are interested, you can read some of these. But you're gonna wanna set both of these to faults. This way it just stops ModAPI from checking the server and downloading the checksum that isn't up to date, because if it's not up to date, it's just gonna keep giving you an error. So once you change these from true, if it's at true, like this. Once you change that, just that inside, no capitals, don't add anything else, don't ruin the brackets, don't delete it like that. Then you save it, Control S, or at the top, save. Close it. Make sure your ModAPI wasn't open when you did that. Now that, again, you've seen that error, you've closed ModAPI, you're going to want to go into your logs. And you're going to want to open up your log and find this line. Neither the game and modded checksum nor the game and the backup checksum did match. Game checksum, this. You're going to want to copy that, just that, then close it. Go back to your ModAPI folder, go into configs, games, the forest, find versions, just like you did before, open that up with notepad. And it's gonna look a little funny, depending on the size that you make it, you can change the organization a little bit. Yours might look slightly different than mine, but it still should have this format. And keep in mind, you still have that checksum, so paste it. Go to the very end, and you're gonna wanna copy from version ID equals whatever, doesn't matter. And then it closes the bracket there, and then it goes checksum, and then it's got that information. And then it has the checksum and then the version. Don't copy to the versions with a plural, it's just a singular version. So version ID to a closed version. So copy that and then paste it. And if you want, you can also format it up to whatever else it looked like. But as long as you didn't take any of these brackets out or do anything like that, it should be fine. Oops, make sure the brackets are right. So you would set this to whatever you want. So like 9 or 60 or B, you know, whatever the version is that you can see on the website, they give you the number and everything. And that's what you want to set it to. Then you want to take this pasted checksum and throw it into this checksum part right here where it's got the checksum and then close checksum. You want to paste it in there. Now, of course, mine didn't change at all. It's the exact same string because I'm actually on 57C right now. So that's accurate for me. When this hits 58, it's going to be a different number. And so I would put in here like 58. And then, you know, it might be different over here. And that's what it would be. After you've done that, you want to save. Control S or up here, you know, you hit save again. I'm not saving because I don't need it. But you do want to save. You don't want to see that little dialog saying, are you sure? Once you've done that, Then it should work when you start ModAPI again. Now if you get an error, let me know down below. There are other issues not related to the update that you may be experiencing. Also, whenever there is an update, including hotfixes, you'll need to do it again. So if they do hotfix B, hotfix C, hotfix D, you're gonna have to do it for every single hotfix. So right after the update, you might have to do this again the next time you turn on the computer, because it's no longer 57, it's 57C. Also, keep in mind that some of your mods won't be working appropriately, and that's a separate issue as well. So if your stats, for example, get frozen, that's most likely the cheat menu, and you can turn off the cheat menu to get your health bar and everything to appear as normal if, for example, you wanted your save anywhere or whatever like that. And again, if you have a 64-bit system, the automatic method I discussed before in the cards and the description, that will be doing what we just did, except much easier and straightforward. So long as you have a 64-bit system and you grab the appropriate prerequisites. Hopefully that helped out and you're now enjoying the new update. I'll be continuing to add to the troubleshooting series, and I look forward to seeing everybody in the next video. Thank you and take care.